My soul, my soul, my soul, say. Hi. When the praises go by,
His glory,
His glory comes down.
When the praises go by,
when the praises go by,
His glory,
His glory comes down.
When the praises go by,
when the praises go by,
yeah. Shall not stand in thy sight.
Hallelujah.
Thou hatest all works of iniquity. Thou shalt destroy them that speak lazily. Mm-hmm. The Lord will abhor the bloody and deceitful men. But as for me, I will come into thy house in multitude of thy mercy.
Amen.
And in thy fear will I worship toward thy holy temple. Mm-hmm. Lead me, O Lord, in thy righteousness, because of my enemies make thy way straight before my face. Amen.
Amen. Bless you, saints. Hallelujah. You may be seated. We appreciate the psalm reading and the prayers. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We really appreciate it. My time is up here. We are going to welcome our precious brother with the announcements. And then he will take forth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, okay, let's try this one, number 45. Please forgive us, we don't have a the device to project. We've got the projector, but we don't have the device, meaning the laptop, to project this morning. So, but I believe you know this song. Hallelujah. You sing these songs at home. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Leaning on the everlasting arm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God bless you. We're going to welcome our precious brother with the announcement. Hallelujah.
I'm leaning on the everlasting.
Amen. Let's give the Lord a little praise. Amen. It is good to be in the house of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I'm happy to see you all this morning. On I think it's 3 weeks now. I'm a bit taller. It's 3 weeks that I've been on Sundays, but those that come on Wednesdays, so one another. So I'm happy to be with you and see you this morning. Hallelujah. How many are happy to be in the house of the Lord this morning? Praise the name of the Lord. You know, just before we make announcement, the brother read a psalm. I think I was attracted to something very interesting in that psalm. I don't know if you believers picked it up. Verse 7 of the same psalm that he read. It says, "But as for me, I will come into thy house in the multitude of thy mercy." So to come in the house is the multitude of God's mercy.
Amen.
Praise be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So sometimes you think you're just coming automatically, but it's God's mercy that will come into his house.
Amen.
Then you continue and say, "And in thy fear will I worship towards thy holy temple."
Amen.
Hallelujah. So in his fear we continue to worship.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So may God issue bless you, children of God. We thank God for the wonderful atmosphere.
Amen.
You know, in the morning, I sent a message to the brethren's group. I think it was around 4 o'clock. You know, as I was praying, and it just came upon me that we should normalize to pray for Sunday meetings, fast for Sunday meetings, and even pray and fast for the ministers that are preaching that day.
Amen.
And you will see the services will never be the same. There will be miracles that happen in the services. Praise be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So we worship like we don't care.
Amen.
You know, God, you don't even care that your wife is next to you.
Yes.
You don't even care if your neighbor is next to you, because you're worshiping the Most High King.
Hallelujah.
So there's the place of liberty. Praise be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So you cannot worship God as if you are not sure about who you're worshiping, you are not sure about your salvation, you are not sure about your life. In the house of the Lord, you worship the Lord. Praise be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I mean, the worship of John caught everyone's attention. The Bible says when he saw the things that God showed him, everything in heaven, on earth, underneath, heard him saying, "Holy, holy, holy." So his worship brought everything to stand still. Praise be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So that is the worship of the child of God. Amen. Before the Futuman and the Red announcement. This morning we've got our visitors. We've got Sister. Is this Sister Tumi or Sister Tumi? Tumi. I assume Brother Robson Malos will be the doctor. So we have Sister Tumi and Sister Ku. Is it Kuhle or Kuhle? How about that? There's H here, there's H-U, K-H-U. Yeah, but it's Brother Robson that was writing. I think he'll forgive you. So Sister Kuhle and Sister Tumi, you may you stand up that we welcome you in the house of the Lord. Saints, may the Lord richly bless you. And this morning, apologies, Brother Nibigani, Brother Sika, they are not with us, they are working this morning. So may we remember them in prayers.
Amen.
And Brother Clement is also not with us, he is in the cell of Mamelodi. Also, may we remember him in prayers. And Brother Luvuyo and family, they are not with us this morning also, they are that cell of Brother Mukani. So we also remember them in prayers, together with Sister Tumi. As you know, they're still Sister Tumi, so they are together that side. So may we remember them in prayers. Then announcements. We have come to that time of the year where we normally plan our mini conventions. So we are planning for them. And there's a day that has came out, which is the 30th and the 1st of November. 30th and the 1st of November, that is Saturday and Sunday. Oh, no, sorry. 30th of November and the 1st of December. 30th November and the 1st of December. Thank you, Brother. So we're going to have two services on Saturday and two services on Sunday. We combined it somewhere with the communion service. So let's remember those meetings in our prayers. We want these meetings to be revivals. We want these meetings to change our lives. We want to mark them as time-tested memorials, yeah. Where we'll see that convention last year, this and this that I've been praying for, God has answered.
Yeah. You know?
So let's fast for them, let's pray for them, and we'll see how the Lord moves. So in that breath, also yesterday we had a ministers meeting in Soweto. The also the planning for the meeting, December conventions, are out. So the conventions in Soweto will start on the 25th. That will be the Wednesday of December. Wednesday will be two services. Thursday will be two services. Friday will be one service. Saturday will be two services. Sunday will be one service. So all in all, we've got total of plus or less 8 services. So we really are going to have a good time. Hallelujah. So just clear your calendar and start planning, because we're going to have a 7-8 course meal this time. For the Lord. Amen. So I'm excited about them. I'm looking forward. So just start planning around them. Normally, they know even at home, I don't visit during December. Yeah. If I visit them in November. Or after conventions, because I think those are special meetings that comes once or twice a year, and one wants to be part of them and benefit from them.
Hallelujah.
So, yeah, that is that. And also, brother Chico, you don't see him here, but he is around. He is working today, and I think that's a lesson to learn. Even on your commitments, if you can come in the house of the Lord, you know, come. And you will see how the Lord bless even the effort. You know. So he is working today. He's somewhere here on the laptop most of the time. He lost his kana buta papa working. Ke ramogolo ne ka sekwa ramogolo ke angel ka moka. So he lost his uncle. That happened on Friday night or Wednesday night. After service, when we got home later that night, he received a call and he had to attend to that. So the funeral is going to be next week, Saturday, I believe in Makapan. Yeah, in Makapan. So those that are around, your support will be appreciated. Remember the family prayers. Pray for them for strength and courage in these testing times. Death is not nice. I mean, even when the person got sick and you saw that, you know what, he's struggling and all those things, but the day they go, it's still painful.
Yes.
So let's remember them in prayers. Hallelujah. May you please remember me in prayers as I'll be traveling on the 25th of December. As I'll be traveling to Cape, I assume it's Cape Town, my sister Nomsa.
Yeah, it's Cape Town.
Yeah, next week sister Nomsa is traveling to Cape Town. So let's pray for her that God gives her traveling mercies. We don't take anything to granted. The devil is setting traps everywhere. So we pray that the angels travel with her. Lord, so let us bow our heads. Lord Jesus, we want to thank you for this wonderful morning. Lord, you are God who answers prayers. Lord, and we are thankful that we are promised, according to the book of Psalms, the entourage of angels to accompany us wherever we go. And Lord Jesus, we pray this morning that may it be so in the traveling of Sister Nomsa, Lord. As she'll be traveling to Cape Town next week on the 25th, Lord, we pray that may you travel with her. May you, Lord, give her travel mercy and safe return back home, O Lord. We depend on you for everything. Lord, even the things that looks like we can do them with our own ability, we still depend on you for them. Lord, because you never fail us. Father God, we pray also for the family of Chico. Lord, as they are going through testing times, Lord Jesus, we pray that you strengthen them, O Lord. You encourage them, O Lord. You become their comforter as you promised. We know that, Lord Jesus, no words can be sufficient to quench the pain that they're experiencing right now.
Yeah.
But Lord Jesus, you quench your pain, the pain, in supernatural way beyond man's ability. We appeal to you that may you do so in the family's life, and may you guide them and help them to have a smooth send off of the angel.
Yeah.
We pray for Brother Clement, who's not with us today, the son of Mammy Lodi. Lord, I want to believe that wherever he is saving the Lord. Lord Jesus, we know his desires to be in the house of the Lord. May you be with him, may you bless him, may he be a blessing that sight. Even Brother Sika and Brother Libigani, Lord Jesus, we pray for them, Lord. We know they always want to be in the house of the Lord. And Father, we know when they are here, Lord Jesus, at 9 o'clock before everyone is here, they are here at church. Cleaning the church, preparing the church. Lord, so for that, we know where their hearts are. Even when they're at work, we are sure that their hearts are here. Bless them, Heavenly Father. Be with them wherever they are. Even the brother, the family of Brother Vuyo, Lord Jesus, the other side of Pastor Mutlana. Lord, I believe they will have their portion this morning. May you be with them, Heavenly Father. May they be a blessing that side. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for all the prayers that you answered, Heavenly Father. You have never failed us, my Lord. You answer prayers. You answer our petitions, Lord. Even the convention that is to come next month, Lord Jesus, we pray for them.
Hallelujah.
That may you go before them, may you do the preparation, that Lord Jesus, when the time comes, Lord, we will just have a wonderful revival in the Lord. We pray for this service, Lord, as you enter the second part of it, which is the part of the word. Thank you for the song service, Lord, that we could feel, Lord, the breeze of the Holy Ghost flowing in this place, Lord. The atmosphere that has been created, Lord, that is such an atmosphere that when the word comes, Lord Jesus, your children will be able to receive the word. We pray for the ministers is coming, Lord Jesus, that may use him as your mouthpiece, O Lord. In Jesus' name we thank and appreciate you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's give the Lord some of praise. Let's just sing a worship song as we are going to welcome the minister. Is he outside, brother? Alright. Let's sing a worship song and we're going to welcome Brother Clue.
Oh, yeah, la la la. Oh,
Let's read from verse 9. Amen. Exodus 24, verse 9. Okay, it reads as follows. Then went up Moses and Aaron, Nadab, Abihu, and the 70 elders of Israel. And they saw the God of Israel, and there was under his feet, as it were, a paved work of sapphire stone, and as it were, the body of heaven in his clearness. And upon the nobles of the children of Israel he laid not his hand. Also they saw God, and did not eat and drink, and did eat and drink. Okay, let me repeat verse 11. And upon the nobles of the children of Israel he laid not his hand. Also they saw God, and did eat and drink. And the Lord said unto Moses, come up to me into the mount, and be there, and I will give thee tables of stones and a law, and commandments which I have written, that thou mayest teach them. Then Moses rose up, and his minister Joshua, and Moses went up into the mount of God.
Amen.
And he said unto the elders, tarry ye here for us until we come again unto you. And behold, Aaron and Hur are with you. If any man have any matters to do, let him come unto them. And Moses went up into the mount, and a cloud covered the mount. And the glory of the Lord abode upon Mount Sinai, and the cloud covered it 6 days. And the seventh day he called unto Moses out of the midst of the cloud. And the sight of the glory of the Lord was like a devouring fire on the top of the mount in the eyes of the children of Israel. And Moses went up into the midst of the cloud, and get him up into the cloud. And Moses was in the mount 40 days and 40 nights. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, Almighty God, we just want to come before you this morning with thanksgiving in our hearts, Lord.
Yes.
My
Almighty God, we come with realization of where we are standing. Many people, Lord, long to stay in this presence, Father.
Yes.
The prophets of old, the men of God of old, mighty
yes.
God, they were even searching as to these things, where do they belong? But Father, it belongs to us, Lord.
Amen.
We want to thank you for your presence, your pillar of fire.
Yes.
We want to thank you for your anointing, Lord.
Yes.
We want to thank you for the message of the hour,
yes.
which is you, Christ.
Amen.
Revealed and manifested in this day.
Amen.
May you bless your children, Lord.
Please.
May you heal them, Father.
Please.
If there's issues in their lives,
yes.
may you resolve them, Lord.
Yes.
Father, we are praying special even for this place, Lord.
Yes.
May you supply their needs as well.
Yes.
The children in this school, Heavenly
Amen.
Father.
Please.
May the cloud, the pillar of fire just come down.
Yes.
And abort in this place, Lord.
Yes.
So that they should see the impact of the word of God in this place, Father.
Yes.
We pray ourselves, dear God, as Christians as well. May your anointing remain with us, Lord.
Yes.
May the Christ, the Logos, just come down now
yes.
and minister to us, Lord.
Yes.
In Jesus' name we pray with thanksgiving. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And you can take the comfort of your seat.
Hallelujah.
Thank God for that. Amen.
So the Lord be blessed.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm just glad to be in the house of the Lord. And then just to think about these things, amen. It's touching, amen. Just to know how privileged we are. And then as believers of this day.
Yes.
I mean, even Hebrews 11 speaks about this great faith, amen.
Amen.
And then that was projected by the servants of God.
Mm-hmm.
Up until even Paul could not count, amen.
Yeah.
He said, what more shall we say?
Yeah.
And then he started naming others, amen. But then at the end there, he says, but them obtaining these things, or rather, they could not be perfected, amen.
Yeah.
Except we be perfect.
Mm-hmm.
So you can imagine how great Joshua was when he stopped the sun.
Mm-hmm.
But that faith of Joshua without us cannot be perfected. Amen.
Amen.
So we are in a great time. The greatest time of all times. Amen.
Amen.
We should be glad for the marriage of the Lamb has come.
Amen.
And we are the people that will actually usher everything in. Amen.
Amen.
So write in your heart, sister, you or brother, you carry something that the world knows nothing about.
Yeah. Yeah.
Something that is so mysterious.
Amen.
They try to study it for so many years, but they can't study it.
Amen.
Because it's an organism, an organic. Amen.
Yeah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So it lives by itself.
Yeah.
And then, so we just thank God for that. Amen. Sometimes I pray that God may open our eyes, that we may understand. Amen.
Yeah.
You know, I was reading here one time in the book of Luke 24. If we can go to Luke 24, amen. Today I just want us to talk, amen, to calm my nerves down. The Lord will bless us, amen.
Amen.
Let's read Luke 24 before we get to our scripture. I guess sometimes it's easy for us to normalize just coming to church and then normalize just being in the presence of God until it cannot impact our lives.
Yeah.
God, you get so used to the impact until it can impact you. But it's a real thing, amen. So if you can check the disciples, they walked with him. They went everywhere with him, amen, that great presence. But I believe it got normal to them to walk with God. So, but we should not allow that, amen. Alright, verse 44. And then it was after the resurrection of Jesus Christ, amen. And then he started to appear to them. And then he appeared to them that were at Emmaus. He appeared to the women as well. And then he appeared to his church at large, amen. Just to prove that he is risen, amen.
according to the scriptures. And he said unto them, these are the words which I speak unto you. These are the words that I speak unto you, while I was yet with you, that all these things must be fulfilled, which were written in the law of Moses, and in the prophets, and in the Psalms concerning me. Then verse 45, then he opened their understanding, that they might understand the scriptures.
Amen.
So I just wish and pray that God will open our understanding, that we might understand the scriptures. Amen.
Yeah.
You see, this message of the hour, Brother Branham even says, it's him, amen, it's Christ. So basically we are feeding on the body weight of Christ.
Mm.
But it is the unseen body weight, amen.
Yeah.
You know, and then God still does great things. I mean, yesterday we were so way today, and Pastor gave a testimony of a certain man. You know how that then Limbobo. So this man was a witchcraft, was a witch doctor, and then now the granddaughter now was troubled by the same spirit. She was sick, and the doctors could not help her. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So and then the grandfather went to her and said, "No, you know what? You must go find a church where they preach the true word."
Wow.
Yeah.
Amen. I don't know the church where they preach the true word. And that father, that grandfather, he's a witch doctor.
Mm-hmm.
And then these things, he said, these things will go once you get to that place.
Mm-hmm.
So all those spirits that are troubling here, all those sicknesses that the doctors can do nothing about, mm-hmm. but when they get to this place where they preach the true word of God,
mm-hmm.
that thing will be sorted, and you do not suffer her anymore, amen, or she will not be suffered of the same thing. And then later in the year, she found a message church, amen, in Zishobo there. So then she was baptized and everything was fine. And then later, you know, the grandfather now was sick now. Because he was saying that the old man, after the repentance of the granddaughter, she began to ask questions, you know, about certain things.
Yeah.
You know, it was explained, or rather it was said that, you know, Limpopo and Pramaraji, I was there, I told Jali that it happened. I know that kind of a story.
Mm-hmm.
This man, they said he had so many cows, sheep, and goats, but he doesn't hurt them, no one hurt them. He just opened the gate, then they go. Then he won't even steal them. They go in the bush, they graze the whole day, and then later they come back, and then in the evening time they come back home. And then all of them know where to come. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So there was another story of the same sort. Just Amatala there. Now I'm giving you the location of the one that I know. Next to Mwetalare. So Tibani. If you know Tibani, amen. So Tibani, there was an old man there, you know, I think he was in FCC or something. Yes, you know. That man, he had so much cattle that he would just take it out into the bush. He just opens the gate, they go. You won't even steal one of them. In the bush, amen. And then they come back home. He doesn't even count them. He knows that they will come back home, all of them, amen.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then they were telling me that one time, you know, this man went there to buy the cattle. So if you don't buy it, you won't even get anything. Mm-hmm. So basically you must first pay the price, and he will tell you, go to the bush and choose whichever you want.
Oh.
But if you don't pay and you just choose, you won't even take it. Or they will be fighting you, those cattle, all of them, amen.
Mm.
So, and then they said, no, you just have to go there, you buy. He doesn't even go with you. He just tells you, you know what, just go to the bush there, you'll find my cattle, and then you choose whichever you want.
Mm.
And then when you get there, then you say, you want this one, it obeys, it complies.
Mm.
Then it gets into your car easily or your bike, then it goes with you. So when he said that, I realized that, no, these things are the truth. So there is the unseen spiritual, or rather there is the unseen world,
yeah.
that most of us, we are not aware of. We are ignorant to the unseen world, amen. We are ignorant to the spiritual world, which actually rules even our natural world.
Yeah.
What are the things that we see here? They are governed by the spiritual world. So if you cannot conquer in the spirit, there is no way you're going to conquer in the natural or in the flesh. So there is no way you can conquer in the physical. Because all that you see here is controlled by something else. Amen. So which you as a believer, you need to come to a place, a point where you can conquer in the spirit. Amen. And the only way to conquer is to follow your message, is to read your Bible, is to pray.
Amen.
And then that is the only thing that can make you to conquer in the spiritual world. Amen. But we are living in the days of seducing spirits. And it is something that we must be aware of. That there is a spirit which have gone out into the world. Amen. And then these spirits are there to seduce. To seduce is to ravish. Amen. Is to take by force. Is to put a... is to force things, amen, or to excite, to attract, to charm, to entice. So they are enticing, they are charming us. And you know, if you can see a young boy there in the street charming a young girl, you know, you then realize that she'll be blushing, but there's a force that is upon her. She doesn't want, but something is pushing her to that enticement, amen, the charming, amen. And then she ends up falling into the trap. And then and now it's history. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So we have a message.
Amen.
That will help us. Amen.
Amen.
We must just be aware
that
we are dealing with spirit.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So we'll come back to this. Amen. Now this old man now. So and then I think he started questioning that. They said his family, the witches of his family now, because it was a family thing, they came to him that, no, why are you disobedient to the spirit, amen. And then he went arguing and all of that, amen. And then he was just sick. And then later now the daughter came and then said, grandfather, you told me that I must find a church. And then these things won't actually operate. And then basically you won't be sick when you find that church, or the spirit won't have impact on you, amen. And then now can I call the pastor? Said yes, call the pastor, amen. And then they called Pastor Mugobi there. And then he spoke to this man. They prayed, the man repented, and then the man was fine. And then the man was baptized, amen. And then the man was fine. So the spirit left and everything was fine. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So, children of God, these things are here. We must just be aware, amen, that the spiritual world, and then we need to take care of that. You know, somewhere Brother Branham speaks about how much we neglect the soul. You know, that the soul is the most neglected thing on earth, and then which is amongst ourselves as well. Sometimes we really neglect our souls, amen. And we focus more on the natural body. But we should not be doing that. Amen. Basically, my sermon today is just to say that if we won't get anything out of it, but just the little thing, maybe let me just give you the conclusion of my sermon before I give you the text. But if you'd like to know, the text will be looking, walking, and becoming. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So you look, you walk, you become. Hallelujah. So you cannot become anything that you have never looked at.
Yes.
That is directly impossible. And then you cannot walk in anything that you have not looked at. So you have to look first, you have to walk into, then you must become. Amen. So then the conclusion of my sermon will just be, or the theme, or maybe something that I want to bring you to, is that let us redirect our focus. Let us redirect our love. Let us redirect our eyes to the pillar of fire.
Amen.
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 Because we have received this message of the hour. And then somewhere, you know, Brother Branham in the church ages, he speaks about the first church age, how that they left their first love. And it is the same thing that is happening today. People are losing their first love. Amen. So may we then redirect ourselves back to the Lord. redirect our focus, redirect our love. We must have our love towards God and redirect our eyes, amen. Because that's the only thing that is going to help us in this day. Blessed be the name of God. I hope it's clear, right? Yeah, so if you didn't hear anything, kindly so redirect yourself to the love of God. Because God is there, He's never gonna move, He's never gonna do anything, amen. Basically, He's just waiting on you, He's depending on you. And then for all this generation, even the saints that I spoke about in Hebrews 11, amen, they are waiting on us. So everyone is waiting on us. So it means there is a lot of, burden upon us, amen. There's a lot of weight that the church is carrying, amen. But at the same time, we must realize why we are here, what we are here for, amen. And then once we do that, then we can refocus our love into a certain place, amen, and channel all of those things. The Bible says that, put not your treasures on earth where moth can easily corrupt, amen. But then put them in heavenly places. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So let us center our focus or recenter our focus back to there. Amen. I believe that we have centered our focus in the message of the hour. We have centered our focus in God. We have centered our focus in prayer. We have centered our focus in just following God and then doing His precept. Amen. But along the way, the thing is, people, once something is normalized, then we lose the impact of it. We lose the value that it brings. Amen. And then we end up just becoming a happy-go-lucky, like I'm living and I'm all of that. Amen. For example, Brother Branham says, we used to pray so many times. We used to have all-night prayers. But then now we are not having them. Why are we not having them? Amen. It means that our focus has shifted back to something else. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So, and then sometimes we used to read our Bibles, we used to pray, we used to, fast, and we used to just, dedicate ourselves to God. That, Lord, we are here, use me, do this with me, all of that you want, Lord. Just use me, amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Let me be thy sanctuary. Mm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But then along the way as we go, because of the trials and all of that, the things of this life, sometimes we slack and then we let go of certain principles. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Up until Jesus told them here that strengthen the things that are remaining. That is in one of the church ages, amen.
Yeah.
So those little things that are remaining, let us strengthen them, amen. We have all of these things. Perhaps you are left with little things, but strengthen the little things that you have. It is later than we think. Amen.
Amen.
So let us walk with this message as we used to walk with it. Amen. And then I give our love to this. You are not giving your love to a man. It is not about a man. It's about the message that the man has brought. Amen.
Amen.
And then this message, it's him, it's God. It's Jesus himself, it's the anointing. And then once you stay in that anointing will lead you into all things. Amen.
Amen.
It will never leave you ashamed. Or anything, amen. Because God cannot forget his children. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You see, when we came in, we applied the token and we took them things out of our lives. We took them things out of our houses. We were lining up with the weight up until that the perfect picture of God was projected before the people will see that you are a Christian. But later along the line, then we start to slag and we go down. Up until then, we receive certain things. Then we can't even ask questions, but why? Why is these things coming back? Why is my life no longer as it used to be? Blessed, why am I no longer praying anymore? You have contaminated your anointing.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So that is where I would like us to come to. Amen.
Amen.
As we are talking about this subject, let us read here in 1 John 2, 17, as we are talking about this anointing. The Lord willing, later we'll talk about it in detail. Amen. But I just want to show you that this pillar of fire is the anointing. And then this is the Christ. Amen. And it is the message of the hour. It's that anointing. Amen. First John 2. And then we read in let's read from verse 20. 24. Let's read from verse 24. Amen. Before we do that, may I just read a quotation here? And then Brother Branham here in the Message, why he says, now we find out that when Jesus was on earth, he said, I come from God and I go to God. That's right. Well, when he died, bruised, or buried, resurrected, ascended on high, we realize that God, that Logos, we realize that God, that Logos, or the pillar of fire that followed the children of Israel through the wilderness, that was Christ. That was the anointing. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So let us read here in 1 John 1, 2, and then verse 24. Let that therefore abide in you, which ye have heard from the beginning. If that which ye have heard from the beginning shall remain in you, ye also shall continue in the Son and in the Father. And this is the promise that he hath promised us, even eternal life. These things have I written unto you concerning them that seduce you. But the anointing which ye have received of him abideth in you, and ye need not that any man teach you, but as the same anointing teach you of all things, and is truth, and is no lie, even as it hath taught you, ye shall abide in him. Amen. Amen. So abide in the anointing that ye have received.
Yeah.
You get me? So we need to abide in this anointing, children of God.
Amen.
To abide, basically, we can call the word stay, but basically is to forever remain. Mm. Abiding is having a permanent a home, a permanent a habitant. Amen. That is to abide. When you abide, it means that thing becomes your permanent home.
Yeah.
It's no longer staying, because you can stay and live. Mm. But after we have come into the anointing, let us abide in that anointing which we have received, amen, in the beginning. And when you receive the message of the hour, you receive an anointing, amen. And then that is the anointing, that the perfect anointing, which is Christ himself, the Holy Ghost, the message of the hour. And it gave a certain nature, a certain spirit inside of you, amen, that started to desire the things of God, and then you were growing as you were going, amen.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. But here, then the thing is, let us remain or in that anointing that we have received. Because it is this anointing that will teach us all things, amen.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm telling you, when you are in this anointing, there is nothing that will hit you by surprise.
Yeah.
Because the anointing teaches you all things. And then a part of that anointing is the discernment of spirit, amen.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And then a part of that anointing is the truth, because the Bible says the anointing is truth and there's no lie. It means if there's something that is wrong and it's a lie, the anointing will actually teach you that that is wrong and that is a lie. Amen.
Yes.
Blessed be the. You need no man to teach you of anything, but the anointing is the one that teaches you.
Amen.
And then Jesus told them that when you receive the Holy Ghost, he will teach you all things. And he will bring you into all the truth. Amen.
Amen.
So let us remain in the Holy Spirit,
Amen,
which is the Logos, the anointing, the
Amen,
pillar of fire. Amen. Or rather the cloud, if you want to put it. Amen.
Yes.
The message of the hour that we've received.
Yes.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Then you don't even need to come to church to be taught on something.
Yes.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. That's why when a preacher speaks behind the pulpit, and then it's like he's correcting, he's picking on the people. There is no such, amen. It is because it's the anointing that does the same thing,
amen.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And now you don't even have to come to the pulpit, to the church where the preacher is preaching. But because people can't listen to the anointing, then it has to come through the pulpit, through a vessel, amen. But it doesn't have to be like that. Basically, you must come to to church having been taught by the anointing.
Amen.
And when you come here, it just confirms what you were taught all the time.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So we need to just to remain in this anointing. But you know, to remain in this anointing is not an easy thing, because it says in verse 26 that the things that I've written unto you concerning them that seduce you. So the seducing spirit that will want to attract you away, to charm you away from the anointing that we've received. Amen. That's why this message of the hour is the most attacked thing on earth.
Yeah.
Anyone, if they want to attack something, they come to the message of the hour. And then they start showing you all of those things. Blessed be the name of the Lord. But that is where the anointing is.
Amen.
Jesus said, no, don't worry when they persecute or do all these things. They so did to your prophet.
Yeah.
And they so even did to Christ. Amen. The very fountain of that spirit, of that anointing, when it was here on earth, it was controversy. So the same thing, when the message of the hour strikes the earth, there must be a controversy about it.
Yeah.
But yet the only selected few must just remain there, in as Peter has said in the word, that to whom shall we go to? Amen.
Yeah.
For thou art the only one who has the word of eternal life.
Amen.
You are the only one that has got the truth. Blessed be the name also. We remain therefore in you. And then as we see things going as they are going in this day, amen, we realize that we come to a point whereby now it's not about looking on to something else on the public, amen. You have to look on to something. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Fix your eyes. Brother Branham says to look is to focus on a particular thing, is to basically fix your eyes, to zero in on something. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So he takes it with like binoculars. That you know what, sometimes he was with Billy somewhere, and then Billy said, Daddy, Daddy, come and see that antelope there, come and see that antelope. And then when he looked through the binoculars, amen, he saw three antelopes. Blessed be the name of the Lord. That's why I'm saying, let us redirect our focus.
Yeah.
Or be intentional with these things, amen.
Amen.
If they don't believe their gospel, our gospel is hid to them, what can you do?
Yeah.
There's no need to impress someone, amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. But I don't know, there's something about message believers. They want to please the world. Or they want to be understood by the world. Amen. The world is never going to understand you as long as you have this anointing. It never understood the God himself. It never understood God in flesh. So it is never going to understand God in flesh again in this day. Blessed be the name of the Lord. They crucified him for the same thing. But if they would have just refocused their binoculars or their focus, amen, and just put them and zero it into one object, they will see that God is one and is the same, amen. So let us refocus ourselves back to the word of God.
Amen.
And then God will help us, amen. So Brother Branham had to now take that binoculars and refocus it, and he saw one antelope after all. Blessed be the name of the Lord. But you see, the thing is with these binoculars and things, after some times, you know, they lose focus, you know. Yeah, their sight, they lose sight. Even your watch, after some time, it loses a time, amen. So you need to readjust it at all times, amen. And then that's why I'm calling ourselves to that. Let us readjust ourselves back into the way. Not readjust ourselves into the world. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
I hope it's clear. Amen.
Amen.
Brother Branham said, apply the token and take them things out. And then I apply the token, be ready, because when the token was applied in that night, in the evening time, and in Egypt, amen, it was the death angel that was following after. It was such an anxious time, a very nervous time, amen. Terrible time. You just had to apply that and look onto your lamp and feed on your lamp, amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
You see, up until Joshua said, don't worry, you can serve the gods of your fathers, the other side of the sea, if you want to. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord.
Amen.
So let us serve the Lord. Amen. Let us just serve the Lord, you know. I don't know how to say it better than this. Let us serve the pillar of fire.
Amen.
Let us serve the message of the hour, you know. That's why I just don't understand. Isaiah 45. You know, we are affected by a few things in our bodies, amen. And those things they control us, amen. And then the five senses of the body. And then one of them is sight. You know, sight is something powerful, right? You look at it, you walk into it, and you become it. I said Isaiah 54. Is it 45? Sorry, Isaiah 45. I'm just looking for Isaiah here. May God help us.
Amen.
Don't lose the vision of Jesus.
Yeah.
I think that's the song that we love to sing. But there is some that are seducing us. That
that want us to lose the vision. 45 verse 22. So here he says, let's read from 21. Tell ye and bring them near, and ye let them take counsel together, who have declared this from ancient times, who have told you it from that time. Have not I the Lord? There is no God beside me, a just God and a Savior, and there is none beside me. Look unto me and be ye saved, all the ends of the earth. For I am God, and there is none like me. So look unto me and be saved. So it means that if you won't look at him, you won't be saved.
Yeah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So you see, looking unto God, basically you look unto him, then you walk into salvation, and then you are saved. Basically you look, walk, become. Amen. So look unto me and be saved, all the ends of the world. Amen. So that is my subject, hallelujah. Looking unto, walking into, and becoming it, amen. May the Lord help us.
Amen.
So, Brother Brenham here says, everything is looking. The Ford company is looking to make a better Ford.
Mm-hmm.
The Chevrolet is looking to make a better Chevrolet. Phoenix is looking to a larger and a better town. The nation is looking for more territory so it can spread itself. The church, just church, is looking for more members. But the bride is looking for the coming of the Lord or of her Lord. We are all looking, but it depends on what the voice is trying to tell you to look at or to look for. Amen.
Yeah.
So we are all looking at something.
Mm.
And I can tell you, we become what we look at. Amen.
Mm.
So you cannot, if you put something here, you're going to become that thing. Amen. If you keep looking at it every day of your life, every moment, when you wake up, when you sleep, you look at that thing, you become it.
Yeah.
Even scientists has proved it. Amen.
Mm.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And then somewhere, you know, that it was David here. He said in Psalm 101, verse 3, you know, he said, I will set no wicked thing before mine eyes. Because to look at a wicked thing, you become wicked.
Mm-hmm.
You see, yeah. Birds of a feather flock together. You look at the same thing, you become that thing. Anyway. I have a nephew, is it a nephew of mine that will... He loved this thing called Popeye, amen, cartoons. And then he even learned English from cartoons. He would just set his eyes on that television. Every day of his life, he was there up until he spoke a better English than all of them in Shebo there, I believe, amen. But no one taught him the English. The Popeye taught him the English, amen. Up until everything that he does now, I think he's about 7, he's about 10 years now. Everything that is done is a Popeye. Amen. So blessed be the name of the Lord. Did you get what I'm going? He looked at something and he walked into it. And then later he became the very same thing that he was just Popeye.
Yeah.
But he's just fun, he's skinny, and then he talks in that way. And then you know, like amen, like he will come to you, do something wrong to me, and then he will be like, I'll beat you, like Popeye, you know, so everything is Popeye, cha-cha, and all of those things, and he's growing up like a Popeye, because he's setting his eyes on something, amen, and then he's walking into it, but he was not realizing that he's walking into that thing, up until his life became the very same thing, amen. So if you look at it, you walk into it, and you become it, amen.
Yeah.
So what about God now? If you walk, if you look unto perfection, you walk into perfection and you become perfection. Amen.
Amen.
So that's what I'm trying to get to, that we can become it. Amen.
Yeah.
We can become it. You can become a God here on earth.
Yeah.
But the thing is, it depends on where you are looking.
Yeah.
Blessed, we are all looking, all of us here. This boy is looking at Popeye, is a Popeye. Amen. But what are you looking at? You look at Popeye as a Christian, you will become the same thing.
Yeah.
A Popeye Christian, maybe, I don't know.
May God help us, amen. And but the thing is, the spirit behind these things.
Yeah.
You cannot act without the spirit.
No.
So this boy received the spirit. Let me tell you something, children of God. They say when they make a movie, right? So there's this thing, there's a spirit behind that, there's an influence that comes on to the director, the script writers.
Because
they meditate upon it, they write it, and then the act must be exactly that. Up until that, when you act it, you become it, amen. Up until you are so enshrouded into that thing, or so swamped into it, until that you become the character.
Amen.
Then you are known by the character. Connie Ferguson, what is the name of Connie Ferguson? It's Karabo. Because he played Karabo well.
Yeah.
Go generation since 2000.
Yeah.
So he was Tau Moal. Even today we still call him Tau. Because of to us, he played the character, but he became the script. And then the script had to come for to come together with the script and to be one. And then this character standing here, even today, he's known, his impact goes across like that. Blessed be the name of the Lord. As that thing. I was told that another lady was also beaten, amen. Don't say I have a TV in my house, but I can be told.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that maybe I can't say, give me you what man now. Ask him some woman. Right. But we are fitting more on in your way. And then the Baba Banagalaga met. She played it so well until that when someone that was watching that thing, this person was looking at this thing up until he gets so irritated and annoyed. And then a rage started growing up until when he saw that lady there. It was up for him. She was gonna beat him. You get it? So she looked at it and it projected the spirit that they wanted you to look. They wanted you to see that and see that there's this thing and this lady did wrong, amen. And then the lady looked at it and wanted to beat her in natural life. There's a spirit behind everything, amen. And we need to be conscious and aware of that fact. That when you look at it, you are not looking at pictures. You are looking at spirits. The unseen world,
amen.
And what are you looking at? What are you setting before your eyes? Amen. So David said, I will not set no evil thing before mine eyes. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So this, remember, it's all spirit, right? I mean, the spirit of God is a spirit and the other spirits are spirits. Amen. And then you set your eyes on the spirit of God, which is the way. And remember, Jesus said that my words are not just words, but they are both spirit and life. So when you look at the word of God, you are looking at a spirit and a life.
Amen.
And then when you now read the word of God, you are reading the spirit and the life of God. It means it comes into you, amen, as the life and the spirit of God.
Amen.
Then later you have to walk into that spirit. Could you start craving and desiring the what the spirit you have received, amen, the nature of that spirit. Then that's why now you want to repent, you want to go out and then confess and then no, I've lied, I've done all of these things, Pastor, I'm such a sinner. You cannot do that unless you receive an anointing.
Yeah.
So there's anointings out there. They make stories like that. They make opais like that.
Yeah.
We are trying to get to a point here. And our end goal is to get the people to behave in such a way. And then they then craft that story. They get characters that will fit this script here. The thoughts, the image that you have, you as a director or as a script writer, you look for characters to fit what is in your mind. Amen.
Amen.
So they are spirits.
Amen.
We are looking at them.
Yeah.
But you see, it depends on what the voice is trying to tell you to look for. Amen. So it's all the case. We can go. I want to give you a story. There was a story of this family. I don't know whether they had 7 kids or what, but then many years ago, but yet in their house, in their bedroom, there was pictures of boats and sea and ships. Amen. So all the time when they wake up, it's a boat. And then when they sleep in the boat, and then they look at it up until from I don't know what age, but until now, when they had to now choose careers, everything was, it was in a sea. on board. The other one was a soldier, a marine soldier. Another one was a captain crew. But they looked at it for all their lives. They walked into it. And then later in their lives, we call it career, they became it. Amen. So, what are you setting before your eyes? Romans 12. Be not conformed to this world. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Be not conformed to the world. But it depends on what you are looking at. Blessed be the name of the Lord. If you look at it, you're going to walk into it and become it. Amen. So if you look into the world, you know, like a great example here is this man called Lot. Brother Branham said the tent of Lot was looking toward a Sodom. Every time when he woke up, he looks towards Sodom.
Yeah.
When he's going to sleep, when he closed the tent, he looks towards Sodom. So up until Sodom now became this great attraction to Lot, up until when the choice came for him to choose, he had to walk into Sodom, amen. Because all the time his spirit was always looking, it was actually living in Sodom, yet he was still in the place with Abraham, amen. That's why when the choice came to him, or he was afforded an opportunity, the first choosing was where you were looking at. So you cannot choose unless you look, amen.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So you look at it, then you become it. That's why, you know what, even our children, they want to be policemen. We grew up in a tough world. Because all that we saw was just police and nurse and teacher. We just want to be that. You ask any child, no, I want to be a police. Because they are looking at police. All the time you're looking at this, no, there's a policeman. You don't see a doctor. Amen. Because back then we'll just go to the clinic. And then it's the next one. That's what we afford.
Yeah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. So Lot was looking at this place, and then he became the place that he was looking at. Even though his righteous soul was grieved, but because he was looking onto that, the anointing that he had received from looking at Sodom, blessed be the name of, he shifted him from the anointing of God that carried Abraham. Blessed, and he became the anointing. You look at Abraham, the same thing. Abraham was looking onto something, amen. And then he was looking to the word of God. He was looking to the promise of God. He was looking to the word. He was looking to God, amen. And then later, and then he walked into God. And he became a God, amen. That's why you cannot replace God. Rather, you can't take Abraham from the Bible. Even God likens himself as Abraham. He had to bring Abraham to be a father and Isaac to be Jesus, amen. To show a picture of this man that was looking unto God, amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And that's why we read it the other day. The Bible said that in Genesis 17, Abraham, walk before me and be thou perfect, amen. Yeah. So you need to walk before something for you to become something, amen.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. But remember, Abraham had to look at God. God said to be visible before Abraham. Then God says, now walk before me and be thou perfect. Amen.
Amen.
And I can tell you, to be perfect, it doesn't mean that I'm not, like as we are doing to our children. Walk before me, you know, we are going that direction. Your child is walking, going there. And then you are following behind. No, that's not what God was talking about. Abraham, walk in my presence. Before means presence. God, basically here you are before me, you are in my presence. In my radius of operation, I see you, amen. So walk before me, look at me, and be thou perfect. All to the ends of the world, look unto me, amen. So Abraham had to walk looking unto something. And then as he walked, he walks into that something that he was looking at all the time, amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And that's why the first thing when he leaves this land of God here, Canaan, the land that God has given, the presence of God. Remember, that land was the presence of God. Somewhere the children of Israel, they did something wrong in that presence, in that land. And then the Bible said, and God took them out of his presence. And then he took them to Nebuchadnezzar there, amen. Out of the presence of God. The land of Canaan was the presence of God, amen. So they had to just walk in the presence of God, in the anointing where they have received, amen. And then when you walk unto that, then you become the very same anointing, amen.
Amen.
So Abraham was looking. And then after looking, then he was walking. Then all of a sudden, the three men were there. And they gave the promise, amen.
Yeah.
And Abraham was perfected. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Lot, on this other hand, he was looking unto Sodom, and then he walked into Sodom, amen. And then he became the very nature of Sodom. Even though his righteous soul all the time was vexed, but he was becoming Sodom.
Yeah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Living in such corruption. So David, what I will not set any wicked thing before my eyes. What are you setting before your eyes, I'm sorry? It depends on what you are looking at. But we are the most fortunate people.
Amen.
Lot conformed to Sodom because he was looking at Sodom. So be not conformed to the world, meaning do not look to the world. But be transformed by the renewal of your mind. And we have the mind of Christ. What is the mind of Christ? It's the word of God. It's the message of the hour. So look unto the message. Then you will be renewed every day of your life. Amen. That you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect and will of God. This anointing will teach you what is good. Will teach you what is acceptable. Will teach you what is perfect. And the will of God. Amen. And Matthew 22. So we are not saying that you must be stereotyped and what. But be careful what you're looking at. We are not saying don't live your life. Live your life, but be careful. What you are looking at. And the way to check that, it's very simple. Look at your diet. What you desire. When you were not a Christian, look at what you desired. Example, just look at your family. What they are desiring. Because maybe you forgot what you were desiring before. Right? And then look at what they're looking at. And then look at yourself. What you are desiring, or what you were desiring after you received the anointing. And then when you look at that, you desired prayer, you desired fasting, you desired praying, you desired reading of the word, listening to the tapes, you desired that, right? And then as you were walking, it was God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. Like everything was just free. It was pure, amen. But later in the time, or later as the years gone by, then you were looking in that anointing. And then you started shifting your focus to something else. And then you left the anointing. Because look unto the anointing and be saved. Amen. Brother Branham says, if you stop confessing that you are saved, means you are looking at something.
Yeah.
You look at yourself and you say, no, me, I cannot be saved. Look at myself. What are you looking at? Blessed be. So some things are humble. They are innocent, but they are not actually innocent. Amen. They are there to seduce you and to take you away from what you have received.
Yeah.
Enticing spirit. Amen.
Amen.
So, yeah, I was looking for this scripture here. And let me get it for you. So that then we should close after some time. Not now. Read the reason that you said you are closing now. Why are you not closing? Okay. I'll look at from Luke 11 here, because it's also here in Luke 11 what I'm looking for. I'll get for you quickly. Okay. Luke 11. Yeah, Luke 11. Verse 34. Yeah. Okay. We will then, after Luke 11, then we'll read that one, because they talk about the same thing, but in somehow the other one, it adds it in a way. Matthew 5, okay, Luke 11, verse 34. It says here, the light of the body is the eye. Therefore, when thine eye is single, thy whole body is full of light. But when thine eye is evil, thy body is full of darkness. Take heed, therefore, that the light which is in thee be not darkened. There is a possibility of the light being darkened, amen. Because of the light of the eye is the, or rather, the eye is the light. The light of the body is the eye. So if your eye be single, and to be single, it means to be focused, to be zeroed. If your eye is zeroed onto the light or this perfection, this pillar of fire, and this anointing, then your whole body is full of light. It is full of perfection because you are looking at perfection. Amen. You are looking at the anointing, is full of the anointing. That's why you don't even have to pray for the sick there. You just be in their presence because you are full of the anointing or the presence. It just heals them automatically. Amen. That's why the body, or rather the shadow of Peter, can heal the people because he's in the anointing. Yeah. So stay in the anointing, because you must take heed therefore here that the light which is in thee be not darkened. There is a possibility of that light being darkened. And how does that light be darkened? Amen. What are you looking at? If thy whole body therefore is full of light, having no part darkness, the whole shall be full of light, as when the bright shining of a candle doth give a light. Amen. So then the Bible said, walk you in the light as he is in the light. So when you look at the light, you walk in the light because he is the light, then you become the light as well. Amen. And then in Matthew 13 later it says, you are the light of the world. How do you become the light of the, or rather the light of the world? Because you are looking at the light of the world and you walked into the light of the world, then you became the light of the world. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So take heed that your light be not darkened. But at many instances, the light becomes darkened. It is not switched off. It becomes darkened. The radiance, amen. You understand what I'm saying again? For it loses a particular amount of light, then it is contaminated light, amen. So let us be careful, therefore. That's what I'm saying. Let us redirect ourselves, refocus. We walk, we look onto, we walk into it, then we become it. I want to read this one here of Matthew 5. Matthew 5, 15. It says here, verse 14, you are the light of the world. A city that is not hid, the city that is set on a hill, cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it into a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine before men, that they may see your good works, and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Amen. So, but let us not allow that light to be darkened. Blessed be the name. So, if your eye is seeing, it's focused, it's zoned onto God, then you will become God. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let's continue reading here. But I hope you understand what I'm trying to bring you to. You know, Brother Branham here says in the message, what shall he do, or what shall he do with this Christ, or Jesus called the Christ? He says here, it is my faith that does that, right? Then he then goes, so he was praying for the sick. It was before he was going on a prayer line. But he was telling the people something that they were not seeing, amen. That right before us, we see the image of a perfect healed person, right? We are looking at it, right? But it's the unseen world. So somewhere in the unseen world, you are completely healed. And then the Bible tells us that God healed all our diseases, right? So we are healed as we are. Even if you are sick, you have what you are healed. Before God, there's a picture there in heaven that you are healed. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So Brother Branham here says, therefore, we see, we are looking in the image, or to the image of a perfect healed person. You here, what we are looking at here is not perfect, right? It is not healed. But we are looking onto something that is healed, perfectly healed that side. And by faith, and then we just make steps by till we step right into that person. So you were sick here on earth, and we just offered a prayer. But when you offer a prayer, there's a picture, an image that is standing before you.
Yeah.
You must just make steps right into it by faith.
Yeah.
Basically, you look at it and then you walk into it, then you become the very image.
Yeah.
That was the unseen, amen. And then Brother Branham said, your body will obey your confession. Basically, your body will obey the unseen spirit and become the unseen spirit, amen. So our body obeys our confession. Because of when you look at something or hear it, amen, and you have to start to speak about it. You cannot look at it or be listening to it and not become it, amen. You'll end up talking about it. I can tell you right now, children of God, if you start going into these development studies and then you start reading, everyone knows here, or accounting. Later you start to talk accounting now.
Yeah.
Everything before you becomes accounting.
Yeah.
Blessed, where does it become? It was not accounting before. But because you started to look, shift your focus on accounting, then every tree becomes accounting. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So that's what I'm saying. Let us refocus. Let us go back to this place where we can refocus. Stop looking at the things of the world and look unto God. There's seducing spirit, whether they are humble or what, but they are seducing spirit. And their intention is just to deviate or take you off from what you are believing. Amen. And then because the devil, the only thing can do to you is to attract you. Because he attracted Eve by intellectual. Brother Branham said so. Eve was attracted by the devil's intellect because she was looking for a new life. She was looking not onto God the way, but looking for something. She shifted her focus off the way into something new. Amen.
Yeah.
And then as she was looking there, then I remember nature doesn't allow vacuums. What you're looking at, and then you start focusing on it, then you become a vacuum. It means you have left the other side.
Yeah.
So then that void in your heart has to be filled by something.
Yeah.
So, and it will be filled by what you're looking at.
Yeah.
Then if you started looking at this thing here, and then you started to question it, amen. And then later there was a man preaching. He doesn't even think that, no, but why don't I go to Adam and ask Adam? Because Brother Branham said now she received the life of the devil himself.
Yeah.
So before she can even partake physically in the spiritual world, she had to receive the life. It means therefore to reject the life, that the anointing that was in her, and receive another anointing. And then in that anointing opens her eyes to something else. It teaches her something else, but that one is lying, cannot be truth. It teaches her a lie, but she believes a lie and she becomes damned by the lie that she believes, amen. Because she's looking onto some another anointing, amen. And then as she looked there, and then all of a sudden, she was naked. She became the very same thing that the devil was attracting her to. Brother Branham said, the devil is not going to take the weight of your hands. Amen. But you are going to hand over the weight to the devil. So how do you hand it over? He attracts you to something. Then you let go of this one. Amen.
Amen.
Where was I reading? Step by step, Eve walked until she stepped right into that person of the wicked. And then she was evil because she had the life of the devil. And she had to conceive the life of a devil on earth. And we are dying today because of Eve looked onto something else. And we are so privileged that even the message says that we cannot fail. It says Eve failed, the bride failed, the Israel bride failed, and then the other bride failed as well at Pentecost. The bride at Pentecost failed as well, but the bride in the end time will not fail. But yet it will depend on what you are looking at.
Yeah.
Remember, Brother Branham says any church that ever organized, and a church is a woman, right?
Yeah.
So, and then a woman is a mixture of male and female.
Mm.
Amen.
Amen.
And then, so as, whatever. Let me put this aside. Okay. I was saying that the church is the woman. So every church that ever organized, meaning that it went and looked and focused onto something, it became that thing, and God shelved it. And the pillar of fire moved on onto the next person. And the pillar of fire keeps moving on onto the next person. The anointing keeps doing that. The thing is, you need to walk in the anointing, amen.
and become the anointing. And once you become that anointing, abide in the anointing. Amen.
Amen.
God, there is no need of you going out. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I hope I'm clear, right? Did you ever see a good grain of corn planted in the ground and let a stick fall over it? It will grow crooked. Let not your light be darkened.
Yeah.
You will grow crooked as a believer.
Yeah.
Not that you are going out. Mm-hmm. You are just growing crooked because you are contaminating the anointings. Amen.
Yeah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So any vine, anything that grows up will because something has hindered it. Well, that's what the matter with the Pentecostal faith today. We have let too many things hinder it. And we have let too many things hinder our focus into God.
Yeah.
We have let too many things come into the way. Amen. We have let too many things just come, and it's home life, it's whatever life that we are living here on earth, to hinder where we are looking at. Amen. But let us redirect our sight. We have let too many things to hinder. The faith that has been taught, the Holy Spirit has been living in us. We have let too many things. Look at somebody else. Amen. So do not look at something else. Let us look into the Word. Amen. That's what I'm trying to say.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. You shift our focus off the Word, then you are off the line. Amen. And that's why backslidings happen. That's why people say, no, why did I leave? Why did I do this? Why did I do this? Why did you come in the first place? You came because you received an anointing, and you leave because you received another anointing. Amen. So, but let this anointing abide in you, which you have received from the beginning. Amen. And as you walk into that anointing, you become that anointing. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed. And then and the latter end of that is to be raptured, or that anointing to rapture. Amen.
Amen.
Because that is the end of it. Amen. If you become perfect here on earth, God takes you home. Because this world is not for perfect people. Amen. You cannot be perfect and remain here on earth. God will take you home. Amen. So, but that is what we are striving for, is to become perfect, is to walk until God says, well done, my faithful servant. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Come and take your position. You have overcome the things of the world. And this anointing, let me tell you, church, even when something comes against it, or rather they say that, you know, when Satan comes like a flood, the anointing, the Spirit will rise up and stand out. Amen.
Amen.
So basically there will be something that comes to you because it teaches you all things. Then it gives you how much of this you must put so that you can overcome the things of the world. There is nothing hid before that anointing. Amen. But when we keep watching certain things and spending time on those things, what are we feeding on? Amen. You become what you are feeding on.
Amen.
All of us here, you become what you have been feeding on. Amen.
Yeah.
If you go to a doctor because you are not eating pumpkin, they will tell you that you are missing pumpkin.
Yeah.
You are eating too much meat.
Yeah.
How do they see the too much meat? Amen. Because you become the meat that you are eating.
Yeah.
So what are you setting your eyes feasting on? You become that. So may God help us. May God help me. Amen. That I may return back to this thing. Amen. I may return back to the days of worship, where we worship was something heartfelt, amen, where you can walk with God and every day of your life you can feel His presence. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
May God help me, may God help you, amen.
Amen, sir.
When that which is perfect is come, then that which is in part is done away with, and we have received the perfection, amen.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. When I was a child, I spake as a child, I understood as a child, I thought as a child. But when I become a man, because when the perfection came, I looked at the perfection, I walked into the perfection, I became a man. Blessed the man Christ, amen. Put away childish things. So let us put away the childish things. They are not evil, they are not wicked, they are not out of the line, but they are childish. You know, there are certain things which are just childish. Let's put on the childish things away. I'm not saying that you are wrong, it can be right, but still childish, you see. If we can put those things away, God will help us. Amen. Finally, brother, farewell. Be perfect. Be of good comfort. Be of one mind. Live in one spirit. The God of peace and love shall be with you. Amen. Let me read something here. So, I saw something one day when Agrakia Feta. I saw something one day when someone was talking about something, amen. We were at White Children of God, and then you see, they were talking about this prophet, an enigma.
Then it may ask me, so I don't mean to. Okay, we're talking about this prophet. Let me not mention the name in this holy prophet or holy place. So anyhow, we were talking about something, you know, because everyone will bring it to you. Agree, you are a Christian. They call you Mfundisi, so imagine they must bring anything to you to validate or to see, but to give your comments to it. And then we started talking, you know, we started talking about the demonology. As you were talking, something struck me. That, but am I aware of the spiritual world? Brother Brennan preached demonology to such an extent. He preached it, I think, I don't know, demonology, then he even came in enticing spirit, showing demonology, amen. He preached it so much that there's nothing to a believer. The anointing, this one was teaching us all things, even the enticing spirit, amen. And then later when we are talking now, because I'm caught off guard as well, I'm there, then these people, I'm starting to narrate or to tell them what I know about this anointing, amen. And as I was talking, then I'm starting to, because remember, when you walk into the light, isn't that you're talking about the light, you're walking into me. When you walk into the light, all those dark spots must flee away, amen. Yeah. And then as I was going in, then I was seeing my life now. That, hey, Mona, you're talking, but what about you? Yeah. There's videos that you're watching.
Yeah.
On YouTube, there are harmless videos. There's nothing that, even if you watch, you won't say no, but brother, you're a Christian.
Yeah.
Who are you watching such things? Yeah. No. it's videos. It's good videos. You can watch about a seed diet, I mean diet on YouTube, but you spend your time there. And then up until you can't even pray. We're talking about this with Brahmanaj.
Yeah.
Up until you can't even pray. Not because it's wrong. No, but just because of you are shifting your focus on something, then you are receiving another anointing. Remember, everyone is governed by spirit.
Yeah.
And then whether they sing in the spirit. They talk in the spirit.
Yeah.
Everything is in the spirit, amen. But it depends what spirit it is.
Amen.
And we are not saying that, you know, now you must not know, listen to people, but be aware of spirit. And the only way to cast spirit is to read the Bible, pray before you sleep and all of those things. And may God forgive me for all of that. Then I start to realize that, but I'm talking about, I'm so versed on demonology and enticing spirit. I don't even say Brother Branham said, I'm just talking. Amen. But what about these things? And I start to realize that there's videos that I watch, there's certain things that I listen to, amen. And then even when my heart says no, stop. You know, sometimes you don't want to stop. You say no, but it speaks of Jesus.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to speak of Jesus to be of Jesus.
Yeah.
Even the devil spoke of Jesus.
Amen.
But did he have the spirit of God?
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us be careful.
Yeah.
So then I realized that, man, I'm spending useless time. Or not useless, sorry, because maybe it's like a Roland again. But I'm spending unuseful. God, I'm losing time. I'm losing time. And I'm looking on to these things. I'm looking on to these things. What am I becoming?
Yeah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
It looked innocent when when the devil was asking Eve. Yet did God say, be careful of the seducing spirit. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Then let us guard ourselves, children of God. Whatever it is, God requires perfection. He requires your repentance. He requires your loyalty to Him and Him alone. And He's looking tonight. No matter how much you have sinned, how little or how much you are still a sinner, you cannot get in no other way but by Jesus. God's all sufficient. That's where Jesus is, or God is looking at, is unto Jesus. And then in Him you are perfected forever.
Amen.
Think of it. We are perfected in Jesus forever. Think of it. It is not nothing you do. It is not a new page you turn. It's not a new life you start. It's a confession of your wrong and a grace, and God's grace to you. That brings you to perfection. Then you are perfected in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But let us look unto Jesus.
Amen.
All the days of our lives.
Amen.
So that we can be perfected. Amen. And let me see if I'm not missing anything. Do you know that music is an anointing?
Yeah.
Amen. You won't sing unless by the anointing. Actually, Paul said, when I sing, I will sing in the spirit.
So are we careful as believers of music that we listen to? We have found one thing, right? Because it's gospel. So if someone will sing like, sorry, this other one will sing Sifela Sa Sion. And then because aren't any filler just you only namele itwanji re retelejano chinchedimwe. For simple, just because we want to worship. I thought the Bible never said that we must listen to songs. It says you must sing in psalms and in what? Yeah, sing spiritual songs and psalms. Yeah. So basically, where can't we sing? After you go, what when you sing? What when you pray once, right? Mm. But when you sing, you pray twice. Mm. Because this music is so powerful that it brings the anointing quicker than any other thing else. And yet we are not concerned about it. May the Lord bless us. Amen.
Amen.
Another brother told me something. He was preaching that in Bogo many months ago, or some months ago. And then, strong stuff. But sometimes we must receive the strong stuff.
Yeah.
Because they are there to help us.
Amen.
Sometimes we lose focus. Our vision gets blacked.
Yeah.
Because of the circumstances and things of this world. Amen. But we thank God for the word of God that can come. This anointing remind us that we are wrong.
Yeah.
You see, that man gave a story. He said that there's people there in Bobo, which spirits are something. These people now, a man hired them to come and play trumpet. You know, Meruba, there we do it, trumpet, and we are playing, then, hey, it's nice, ne? They will play gospel in that trumpet.
Yeah.
Like, we call those people, right, you know them, a team, a band of people, and then they play so well that you can even cry if you're not careful. So those people, they were playing that thing, and then later they said, no, but we are playing so good, and this man is not paying us. They started complaining that, no, the man is not paying us, and then good, and then we are playing so well, and then we are getting gigs. We are playing, we are getting gigs every time, amen. You see, and he's not paying us. And then they went to complain to someone else, and that guy came to this man and said, Mona, why are you not paying your people well? He said, oh, why? He said, no, they said they are playing so well and you can see them. Why are you not paying them well? He said, oh, so were they the ones playing? Okay, fine, let them come and play. Then they now came and played now. Ah, the trumpets were going every direction. Corey, that choreography, that singing was not there.
Yes, sir.
The symphony, they were not keeping the symphony, amen. When you asked them to come and play, and then he said, okay, now who's playing? Amen, who's playing?
Yes, sir.
So don't just look onto a gift, but look onto the spirit behind the gift.
Yeah.
The Bible said we discern the spirit.
Yeah.
We are not discerning how nice, how good, or what this song is. We are discerning the spirit. Whether it's a sermon or not, we are not discerning the sermon. Our souls cannot discern words, it discern the spirit. Amen.
Amen.
And then that's what the anointing is doing.
Amen.
And then he said, okay, so now then you're playing. No, you play. Then they couldn't play it. He said, okay, it's fine. His people were playing, or rather the spiritual world was playing. Good, once you come there, then they give you something, maybe you drink something, or you get into something, then you meditate until that spirit comes into you, then you check up, then you start playing, amen, but the anointing that plays the music inside of you. You are just a vessel, but Abraham says, no, like me now preaching, this thing here is just a transmitter, it has got nothing, it's void, it has not got voice, but there must be someone behind it that speaks to it and it transmits. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So be careful.
Yeah.
What do I listen to?
Amen.
I must be careful. What I'm watching, what I'm listening to. Amen.
Amen.
Because I'm going to become those things. But Moses. God called Moses. Yeah. But God called Moses. And then he said, Moses, come unto me. So Moses was looking at God. God said, come unto me. And then when Moses went unto God, he went into a cloud, into the pillar of fire. And when Moses left there, his face was shining. He was the pillar of fire. It was shining, amen, up until the people could not behold Moses because of his radiance. He was shining, amen. So Moses had to put a veil upon himself so that he can speak to the people, amen. Because he went, he looked at the pillar of fire, he went into the pillar of fire, then he became the pillar of fire, amen. When Moses was speaking, it was as if God spoke. You would not even Moses can tell God that, no, repent of your evil thinking, amen.
How do you just want to destroy these people? The world outside there, they will see that, no, but you brought them here and then you killed them because you couldn't take them in. So repent, Lord. How can Moses tell God to repent? It was the anointing in Moses that was speaking to the anointing, amen. It was basically God reasoning with himself.
Yeah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Yeah. So you look at it, you go into them, you become it, amen. That's why, hallelujah. Then he corrected others because they were new people. That why did you go to a certain place? Why did you go to a certain concert?
Because when the people were there, they were playing good. They went out to another place, and then their fame went down. He was saying that. And then they came back, their fame went high.
What spirit are we feeling on?
Is it the truth?
Yes.
So if you are here, your fame goes higher. You go out of this place, your fame goes down.
Yeah.
You come back, your fame goes higher. What happened in that place that you went to? At the second place,
yeah.
It means you didn't have the same anointing that you carried,
yeah,
in the first place.
Yeah.
Because when you return back to that same place, you get the same anointing.
Yeah.
But these things are hard truth to speak about.
Yes.
Because of favoritism, worldly things,
yeah,
that are can carry us, amen.
Mm-hmm.
But anointing,
amen.
It's very important.
Yeah.
Amen. So I hope we understand each other. I'm not saying anything. But I'm just saying that there's an anointing that we must abide in.
Amen.
Let us go back to that anointing.
Amen.
For the children of God, it doesn't matter whether you are called a nobody or nothing. For if they are to call you a stereotype, let them do so.
Amen.
Jesus was called the same. Or if we're living in the days, or if Jesus was living in this day, they will call him a robot, a stereotype. But he said, the son can do nothing himself, but what he see the father, the anointing doing, the son doeth likewise. So we also, we must come to that place that we can do nothing in ourselves until we see the anointing in us doing it, then we do it. Because we are remaining in the right anointing, the true anointing, amen. Then you will be perfect, you will have victory. So let the world call you what they call you. It doesn't matter, we are looking unto God.
Yeah.
Let all these things come, the enticing spirits, ours is to live in the word.
Yeah.
And then if you are to die, let us die in the word. We better die before we backslide. We must purpose it in ourselves that, Lord, let me die before I leave this anointing. God, better God take me home than for me to do something. Amen. So may the Lord richly bless you. If there's something, I know I have done certain things. I'm telling you about myself. That I've seen that sometimes we darken the anointing, or we darken the light that we have because of certain things that we look onto. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So let us just be careful of those things and then focus on them. Let me review the last quotation and I'm done. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
I could do it. We must cope our lives and focus in, or we must cope our lives, which is where we are struggling, coping our lives. We must cope our lives and focus it into the word of God. Just like we would picture camera, or try to get the right focus before we snap it. Like, you put the camera, then you want to focus it before you snap it. Amen. So the same way, but we need to focus, right? And then after we focus, before we snap it, and then we got the real true picture. That's what we want to do, to focus our lives into Jesus Christ, that Christ and you become the same person. Amen. You are an adopted a son or daughter of God by the blood of Jesus Christ. Then the church will be moving on without friction, without hurt, without harm, without doubt, without scruples, without friction. It would be moving in the power of the word of God, manifesting every divine blessing that God promised it. If it would just do that, focus, refocus. If you can just refocus before you snap it. If you do that, you will move into those things. Amen. We must do our lives. We must do our lives and then see him only. not only a bishop, some great man, something we pattern, we take pattern by, but we look to Jesus Christ, not some organization, not some pope, not some archbishop of Canterbury, or some divine man that we call on the earth, but we must look to Jesus. Is he is the way. Abraham, when he was asked to sojourn into a strange land, he looked for the promise and never doubted the promise. Amen. The Christian looks at the unseen. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So let us rise to our feet.
Amen.
God is blessing church. Let us let our eyes be singing. And then our whole world will be full of light. So if your spiritual eye is singing, then your whole body will be, your whole spiritual life will be full of light. So let us take heed that the light that we have be not darkened. Amen.
Amen.
I could have said many things, but we have to stop here. Amen. So let us sing a song. And then hallelujah. Amen. As we are coming to pray, amen.
Thank you.
spoke to our hearts. Wherever you are, just raise your hands
and say, Lord, we are thankful for bringing to our attention that we have to be cautious of the things that are happening in their spiritual lives. The brothers hope that before things happen on the outside, it started in the spirit. If in the spirit, before she could fall on the outside, she desired wisdom before she could succumb to the spirit. Lord looked at Sodom until he became Sodom before he even went to Sodom. And Paul says in 2 Corinthians, for we are not ignorant of his devices. And this morning, the devil's devices have been set before us. You can see all of them. And brother and sister, let me tell you, the devil's purpose is to destroy you. Finished. He wants to destroy you spiritually. And he's not going to come and say, here I am, I'm here to destroy you. Brother Branham says, is amalgamation of all the horse powers. And he never had a name before. But this time he's got a name, and that name is death. And Brother Branham says, hell is following him. And hell comes with all the types of spirits that want to make you a weak Christian. The devil wants to ensure that you don't come to the level of perfection that you should be. The devil wants to ensure that you don't overcome your condition. He wants to ensure that you remain a weak Christian. And he does that through the spirit in the unseen world, and you're not even conscious of it. But God loves us so much that he inspired our brother to bring these things to our attention this morning. So we are going to pray. And with your hands raised like that, we are going to pray, and we are going to pray for everyone. And you make a genuine prayer in your heart for God really to help us to interrogate everything that we do, because the spirit behind everything in our lives. And like the brother says, some things don't even look even innocent things. But the purpose is just to take our time, ensure that we don't focus on the things of God, becomes weak, tired, and sleep. But today we thank the Lord that these things has become before our attention. So as we are going to pray, all of us, I'm going to lead you in prayer as you also pray. Lord Jesus, we want to thank you this wonderful morning. Lord, for using our precious brother so wonderful. Lord Jesus, we are thankful that, Lord, all the devices, the tactics of the devil are laid before us this morning through the preaching of your word. Lord, we are thankful, Heavenly Father, that, Lord, we are being made aware that every time we are in our highest spiritual form, there's an anointing in that. Every time we are doing contrary on the lowest, there's an anointing that is making us to do that. And Father God, we are thankful that you love us so much that you came down and spoke to us in such a manner. We are thankful, O Lord, that you reminded us that everything that we see is made of things that is not seen. Lord, the world that we see, there's a world that is unseen. Lord, we know that there's heaven, Father, there's atmospheres. Lord Jesus, we know that there are dimensions that we don't see, but they're influencing our lives every day. And Father, what after this sermon, look, walk, and become, Lord, as crystal to us. Lord Jesus, we are thankful that you brought us to consciousness of the dimension of the unseen world. And Father God, now we know that there's a fourth dimension that is influencing the lives of many and our lives in some parts. Lord Jesus, we are reminded that there's a heavenly dimension. There's a sixth dimension that has to influence us. Where, Lord, we have to walk every day to the influence of that eternal body, that fearful body. Lord, as the brother mentioned through the quote, that when we pray for a sick individual, Lord, you heal him, and his faith walks him back to that eternally healed body of his that is in the image of the fearful. Heavenly Father, this morning after this sermon, Lord, by faith, O Lord, we are back stepping back into that body, Lord, that we originate in. That body that is perfect.
Lord, help us, Heavenly Father. Forgive our sloppiness. Forgive our ignorance. Lord, let the devil take advantage of us. Lord, we are not ignorant of his devices anymore, because he's looking for every opportunity. Lord, he wants to take advantage of every opportunity. But oh Lord, we are thankful that Lord, we've got the high priest that can be touched by the feelings of our infirmities. And Lord, this morning, this afternoon, we are touching you, oh Lord, as we are repenting, Heavenly Father, from hearing the things that we heard. Lord Jesus, there's no man that can speak like that, lest you spoke through him. We want to thank you, oh Lord. We pray that you forgive us, my Lord. We pray that you forgive our sloppiness, our laziness. We pray that you forgive our ignorance. We pray that, Lord Jesus, you forgive, Heavenly Father, our lack of interest, our lack of determination, our lack of intentional motives. Father, forgive us, my Lord. Oh, Father, help us. Help us to be serious about your things. Help us, oh Lord, to remain in the spirit and the anointing of the Lord. Help us to be first year church. Help us, Heavenly Father, to come to church every day. Help us, Heavenly Father, to pray every day. Help us, my Lord, to read the word every day. Help us, Jehovah, to listen to the preachings every day. Because what we look at every day, we become that, oh Lord. Father, God, may you help us, Heavenly Father. We are surrendering all. We are repenting, Heavenly Father. We pray that you forgive us, our Lord. We thank you for your love that you said in the Bible, those that you will love, you rebuke and chasten. And Lord, we feel love today because we are chastened. We are rebuked, oh Lord. That is interpretation of love to us, Heavenly Father. And we are thankful, Lord. If you did not love us, you would have left us to just continue like that. Coming to church, going back home every day, but Lord, our spiritual condition remained the same. Lord, you would have left us like that without growing spiritually, without having higher ambitions in the spirit.
Right.
Lord, just floating and idling, Heavenly Father. Lord, we are thankful that you love us so much. Amen. We are thankful, oh Lord. We are thankful, oh Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Touching Jesus, it's all that matters, and your life, and your life will never be the same. There is only to touch you, just believe when you call on his name. Touching Jesus, touching Jesus, it's all. Something wonderful hand.
He touched me.
He touched me. Oh, he touched me. And oh, the joy that floods my soul.
Something wonderful happened.
Oh, something wonderful happened, and now I know Jesus touched me and made
until they enter into another level. And the way they perform, the way they sing, there's something that has to take them there. Hence, most of them, they cannot even cope, they have to go into drugs. They say you cannot do what they're doing normally. It's because of the anointing and the spirit that goes with that. So we really have to be cautious, children of God. We have to be cautious. And Paul says, 2 Corinthians chapter 2, let the devil take advantage of you. Let us not be ignorant to his devices. They are so innocent. His devices are not. Satan won't come to you with alcohol. He knows you won't drink. He won't come to you with kabanyan. He knows that he won't fall into that. But he comes with the so little innocent, seemingly innocent things.
Yeah.
No wonder we cannot have breakthroughs when we pray. No wonder your spiritual life is either it's like this or it's like this. It's because of these other things that we are doing in our lives that look so innocent. But yet the purpose is to just make you a lukewarm Christian. We were talking about gifts yesterday with Brother Paul. That there are so many gifts in the church, but the devil is suppressing them. Because children of God, we are not coming to a deliberate level where we want to grow spiritually and take the steps to go there. So may the Lord richly help us. May the Lord help us. We thank God for this kind of sermons. If you appreciate this.